while back, I was thinking about it, something that happened to me when I was a little kid. And I was thinking about that week back when I was about 9 years old, that we started studying castles in school. Me and my buddy Ryan, we thought castles were the coolest thing in the entire world. So we decided that when we got home that day, we were going to build ourselves a catapult. So when we got home that day, we found out that my mom, she wasn't home. So I ran outside behind the house real quick, as fast as I could, and I got together a bunch of 2x4s, and we brought those out front. And Ryan, he ran into my garage and grabbed some hammer and nails, and we came out front, we started throwing that thing together. We were hammering the sucker together as fast as we could. We put a little A-frame base on it with a nice 2x4 bent over the top. Well, of course, this thing was a bit bigger than me, so me and Ryan had to attach a rope to the top of it, pull it down real tight, both of us, attach it to the base. Put a nice knot in that thing, and it was all ready. So we attached a nice basket right on top and put a rock in that basket. Well, about that time, we got ready to fire it, went to release the knot, and it wouldn't come loose. The thing had cinched down real tight. So we decided, how the heck were we going to get through that thing? And we thought to ourselves, well, I'm not allowed to use any of my mom's good cooking knives on stuff like this, so we decided to burn through the rope. So I immediately ran back inside to go get a candle so that I could burn through this rope. When I found the candle, I had to go get the matches. So the matches were contained in a spice cabinet above the stove in my house. I had to climb up on top of that stove and start going through the spice cabinet. Before I found those matches, I knocked over a bottle of oregano under the counter. It fell out down and popped open, and the oregano spilled all over the counter. I didn't handle mine, so I just reached up and looked in there and found those matches finally. So I jumped down and went to light that candle with those matches, but the only problem was that the matches kept going out before I could light the candle, so I decided to light it on the stove. So I turned on that stove, put the candle up to it, but even the stove wasn't lighting now. So I decided, okay, I better light the stove with the matches so that I can light the candle with the stove. So I put the candle on the stove, took out the matches and lit it, put it up to that stove, and the gas jumped. Just jumped, and the match jumped right out of my hand as it happened. Fell right over on top of the counter. Now, I hadn't realized that oregano was so flammable at that time. But that counter just lit up like the 4th of July. So at that moment, I was just did whatever any 9-year-old would do at that moment. I just screamed at the top of my lungs. All of a sudden, in comes Ryan real fast, and he sees what's going on. He turns on the sink and starts throwing water all over everything that was burning. So we got the whole thing, you know, all put out, and there was water just all over the kitchen. But I noticed that, you know, now we didn't have anything alight. And then I looked on the counter and realized that one of my mom's good cooking spoons was still on fire. So we decided to use that to burn through the rope. So we took it out there and we were down there real good, burning through that rope, just waiting for it to go, and all of a sudden, swing, and the just flips that rock right across the yard. And it went all the way across the yard, and all the way across the street, and all the way across the neighbor's yard, and right through his front window. At that moment, he just did what any 9-year-old would do, and just stood in awe and wonder. About that time, out through that window comes bounding this little Jack Russell Terrier. This was the meanest dog in the entire neighborhood. This dog comes running after us, so we just bolt across the yard. And we're running as fast as we can go. And we immediately see the treehouse, so we run up the treehouse. It was only about 5 feet off the ground, and this dog was about this big. I know we were only about this big, but the dog was, you know, intimidating enough for us. So we're up there, and all of a sudden, my buddy Ryan realized that he needs to go home and take his pills. So he's just going to risk it. The dog's down there just waiting for us like a shark. So he gets ready and just runs and jumps. And he's running across the yard as fast as he can go, and that dog's catching him. So he turns around, sees that dog catching him. He starts looking somewhere to climb up. And the first thing he can see is the catapult. So he runs up the yard with the catapult. Sits up there perched on the basket. Well, that dog just followed him right up the catapult. He turns around and sees that dog there, and just about before it gets him, he jumps off the catapult, and it flings that dog across the yard, and across the street, and across the neighbor's yard, and back through the window. Dog didn't get back out, so we figured he was done. So basically about that time, we saw what had happened, and we realized that we need to get rid of this catapult. Well, me and him started getting down. I tried to move the catapult, but it wasn't moving. It was too big for us. So we decided that we would burn it down. I ran outside behind my house again, went and got the white gas out of the shed. And my buddy Ryan runs up into the house and grabs the matches that I dropped. We run back down there, and I take that gas, and I'm pouring it all over the thing, just getting it everywhere, make sure it's good and coated. Take a couple steps back, and Ryan takes a match, strikes it, flips it on there, and the thing just erupts in flames. It was beautiful, so we just stood there and stared at it for a bit. Then all of a sudden, one of the sparks pops up off the thing and lands on my shoes, and they burst into flames. So I take off running around the yard in a circular pattern, hoping that maybe the vortex will happen and put my shoes out like they did on TV. You know? So immediately, Ryan runs into the rescue again. He pulls out a water hose, and he starts spraying me down and finally relieves me of that burning sensation I'd always heard about in church but never really understood. About that time that my shoes were out and I was all relieved, the gas pan, which I had left next to the catapult, explodes and leaves a crater about 10 foot wide in the middle of my yard. So I had always realized I wanted a swimming pool. I grabbed that hose and started filling the thing up. About then, my mom comes home. She's all like, "Have you been digging holes in the yard?" "Yeah." "That's what I've been doing." So, me, actually, she sends Ryan home, which was good because he needed to go home anyway. And she takes me inside and has me turn off the hose. And we go into the house and we see that there's a... We walk into the kitchen and we see that the kitchen is totally covered in water. And she's all like, "What happened in here?" And I'm like, it's pretty much caught at that moment, so I just told her. Built the oregano and was trying to clean it up. So immediately she's like, "Well, go get some towels. The next time, just use a damp cloth." I immediately run out and get some towels and run back in and start cleaning up the floor. And I've got a pretty good drive by then. When my dad comes home, he's all like, "What happened?" She's like, "Oh, your son was digging holes in the yard again." He's like, "Oh, okay. That's all right." He's like, "Hey, did you hear that our neighbors, apparently somebody broke into their house and darn near killed their dog?" She's like, "Really? Somebody must have really hated that little dog." About then, she looks around the kitchen, "Now, where's my good cooking spoon?"